Harry Potter. Are not 2 hour draws on the pace. 4 happy days bring in another moon.
4 days will quickly steep themselves in the night. 4 nights will quickly dream away the time. And then the moon, like to a silver bony bent in heaven, shall behold the night of our solemnities.
Look at them, fools. So sad, pulling their hair out over the pains of love. Oh, love, love, love. Been watching this little jar of cookies for weeks. It gets messier and messier every day. I love it. Would you like to come with me and follow the saga of the heart? Let me fill you in. That's Theseus. He's the Duke of Athens, and his word is law. He's trying to send out announcements about his upcoming wedding to Hippolyta, but his friend Aegis is arriving with a problem. Aegis is upset because his daughter Hermia and that guy she loves, Lysander, are here too. But wait, who's this? Oh no, Aegis wants his Hermia to marry that other man, Demetrius, not Lysander. Aegis is coming to the Duke to make her obey.
My lord, full of vexation come I with complaints against my child, my daughter Hermia. Stand forth, Demetrius. This man has my consent to marry her. Stand forth, Lysander. This man has thou filched my daughter's heart, turned her obedience, which is due to me, to stubborn harshness. As she is mine, I may dispose of her, which shall be either to this gentleman or to her death, according to our law.
What say you, Hermia? Demetrius is a worthy gentleman.
So is Lysander. I beseech your grace that I may know the worst that may befall me if I refuse to wed Demetrius.
Either to die the death, or to abjure forever the society of men.
So will I grow, so live, so die, my lord, ere I will yield my virgin patent up unto his lordship.
Lysander, yield thy crayfish to my certain right. You have her father's love, Demetrius. Let me have Hermia's. Do you marry him?
Scornful Lysander!
My love is more than his. My fortune's every way as fairly raped.
Demetrius, come, and come, Aegeus. I have some private schooling for you both. Fair Hermia, look you arm yourself to fit your fancies to your father's will, or else the law of Athens yields you up, which by no means we may exonerate to death or to a vow of single life.
Gonna do?
Sing a song?
Shh! I have a widow aunt, a dowager of great revenue, and she hath no child. From Athens is her house remote 7 leagues, and she respects me as her only son. There, gentle Hermia, may I marry thee, and to that place the sharp Athenian law cannot pursue us. Steal forth thy father's house tomorrow night, and in the wood will I wait for thee.
I swear to thee, by Cupid's strongest bow thou hast appointed me. Tomorrow truly will I meet with thee.
Are they nuts?
It's Hermia's best friend, Helena. Look, they're telling her about their plan to run away and get married. Well, that was easy. Everything's fine and dandy. Hermia told their friend about their little plan to run away and secretly marry. One small problem. Helena's in love with that Demetrius guy, and she might use the secret to try to win his thanks.
How happy some, or others some can be. Through Athens I am thought as fair as she. But what of that? Demetrius thinks not so. I will go tell him of fair Hermia's flight. Then to the wood will he tomorrow night pursue her. And for this intelligence, if I have thanks, it is a dear expense. But herein mean I to enrich my pain, to have his sight thither and back again.
Mary, our play's the most lamentable comedy and most cruel death here, Mrs. Bisbee.
What have we here? 3 wise men? I think not. More like 3 doofuses.
Doofy.
They're preparing to put on a play of their own. Do you think they can do it? They meet to perform it at the Duke's wedding party. He's called Fluke. Great name. Who wrote this?
William Shakespeare.
I know that. Okay, that guy's Quince and that one is Bottom. Another great name. I smell trouble for these fools.
Name what part I am for and proceed.
You, Nick Bottom, are set down for Pyramus.
What is Pyramus, a lover or a tyrant?
A lover that kills himself most gallant for love. Flute, you must take Thisbe on you.
What is Thisbe, a wandering knight?
It is a lady that Pyramus must love.
Nay, Faith, let me not play a woman. I have a beard coming.
You shall play it in a mask, and you may speak as small as you will. Now, meet me in the palace wood, a mile without the town, by moonlight. There will we rehearse.
We will, and there we may rehearse most obscenely and courageously. Take pains, adieu.
At the Duke's Oak we meet.
Do you believe in fairies?
Yeah.
Some really important fairies are over there, right now.
Ooh.
Quiet! Not just any fairies. Oberon and Titania, the king and queen of fairies. So, everyone must be on their best behavior. Things have not been hunky-hunky-dory in fairyland. Oh no, Titania and Oberon have been fighting for weeks.
Why?
I don't know exactly. Something about the little orphan child they adopted. Oberon wants the child to be with him, but Titania's still mad about something that Oberon did and won't give the child up. There's Oberon, and he has Puck with him. I know all about her. I would watch her very closely.
Ill met by moonlight, proud Titania.
What? Jealous, Oberon?
Tarry, rash wanton. Am I not thy lord?
Then I must be thine lady. But I know when thou hast stolen away from fairyland, and in the shape of corn sat all day playing on pipes of corn and versing love to amorous Phyllida.
That's what it is! He was making goo-goo eyes at some other lady, and she's still mad at him!
How canst thou thus for shame, Titania? Knowing I know thy love to Theseus.
These are the forgeries of jealousy.
Do you amend it then? It lies anew. Why should Titania cross her Oberon? I do but beg a little changeling child to be my attendant.
The fairyland buys not the child of me. Her mother was the votress of my order, and in the spiced Indian air by night, full often hath she gossiped by my side. But she, being mortal, that child did die, and for her sake do I rear up her child, and for her sake I will not part with her.
Give me that child, and I will go with thee.
Not for thy fairy kingdom. Cobweb away, we shall chide downright if I longer stay.
My gentle Puck, come hither. Fetch me that flower, the herb I showed thee once. The juice of it on sleeping eyelids laid will make or man or woman madly dote upon the next live creature that it sees. Fetch me this herb, and thou be here again ere the leviathan consume a league.
I'll put a girdle round about the earth in 40 minutes.
I love thee not, therefore pursue me not. Where is Lysander and fair Hermia? The one I'll slay, the other slay me.
You draw me, you hard-hearted adamant.
Do I entice you? Do I speak you fair? Or rather, do I not in plainest truth tell you I do not, nor I cannot love you?
And even for that do I love you the more.
Tempt not too much the hatred of my spirit, for I am sick when I do look on thee.
And I am sick when I look not on you.
Hast thou the flower there?
Aye, here it is.
I know a bank where the wild thyme blows, where ox slips and the nodding violet grows. Quite over canopied with luscious woodbine, with sweet musk roses and with eglantine, there sleeps Titania, sometime of the night, lulled in these flowers, dances in delight. And with the juice of this, I'll streak her eyes and make her full of hateful fantasies. Take thou some of it, and seek through this grove. A sweet Athenian lady is in love with a disdainful youth. Anoint his eyes, but do it when the next thing he espies may be the lady. Thou shalt know the man by the Athenian garments he hath on.
Fear not, my lord, your servant shall do so.
Ooh, this is getting good. Oberon's gonna use his magic eye drops on his queen Titania and lend a helping hand to sweet Helena, too. The juice of it on sleeping eyelids laid will make or man or woman madly dote upon the next live creature that it sees.
Be it ounce or cat, in thy eye that shall appear. When thou wakest, it is thy dear. Wake when some vile thing is near.
It's them! They really did run away!
Well, rest us, Hermia, if you think it good.
Be it so, Lysander. Find you out of bed, for I upon this bank will rest my head.
Through the forest have I gone, but Athenian found I none. Night and silence, who is here? Weeds of Athen he doth wear. This is he, my master said, despised the Athenian maid. And hear the maiden, sleeping sound, on the dank and dirty ground. Churl! Upon thy eyes I throw all the power this charm doth owe.
No!
Wrong guy!
Idiot, now what?
Shh, someone's coming.
I charge thee hence, and do not haunt me thus.
Oh, wilt thou darkling leave me? Do not so.
Ugh.
Oh, I am out of breath in this fond chase.
But who is here?
Lysander on the ground? Dead or asleep? I see no blood, no wound.
No, wrong guy!
Don't wake him up!
Lysander, if you live, good sir, awake.
And run through fire I will for thy sweet sake.
Lysander, say not so. Hermia still loves you. Then be content.
Content with Hermia? No! I do repent the tedious minutes I with her have spent. Not Hermia, but Helena I love. Who would not change a raven for a dove?
I thought you, lord, of more true gentlemen.
Lysander? Lysander!
Lucky for her, she slept through all that. Oh, our actor boys.
Actor boys.
Come, sit down, every mother's son, and rehearse your parts. Pyramus, you begin. When you have spoken your speech, enter into that break.
What hempen homespuns have we swaggering here? So near the cradle of the fairy queen. What? A play toward?
I'll be an auditor, an actor too, perhaps, if I see cause.
Speak, Pyramus. Thisbe, stand forth.
The flowers of odious savor sweet.
Odors! Odors!
odor savor sweet. So hath thy breath, my dearest Thisbe dear. But hark, a voice! And stay here a while, and I will return.
Must I speak now?
Aye. Most radiant pyramids, most lily white of hue, as true,
yuck.
As true's horse, they yet would never tire. I'll meet the pyramids at Ninny's tomb.
Bottom, your cue is past. It is never tire.
Fair, Thisbe! I were only thine. Why do they run away?
What angel wakes me from my flowery bed? I pray thee, gentle mortal, sing again. Thy fair virtue doth move me to swear I love thee.
Methinks, mistress, you should have little reason of that.
Out of this wood, do not desire to go. I do love thee, therefore stay with me. I'll give thee fairies to attend on thee. Peace blossom.
Ready.
Cobweb.
And I.
Come, wait upon him. Lead him to my bower. Tie up my lover's tongue. Bring him silently.
Great. Now she's in love with a donkey.
Yee-haw! Yee-haw!
Hey!
I wonder if Titania be waked. Then, what it was that next came to her eye?
My mistress of the monsters in love. While she was in her dull and sleeping hour, a crew of patches were met together to rehearse a play intended for great Theseus' nuptial day. The shallowest thick skin of that barren sort, who Pyramus presented in their sport, forsook his scene and entered in a break. When I did him at this advantage take, an ass's knoll I fixed it on his head.
This falls out better than I could devise. But hast thou yet latched the Athenian's eyes with the love juice I did bid thee do?
I took him sleeping, that is finished too.
This is the same Athenian.
This the woman, but not this the man.
Oh, I rebuke you, him that loves you so.
Thou, I fear, hast given me cause to curse if thou hast slain Lysander in his sleep.
I am not guilty of Lysander's blood.
I pray thee, tell me then that he is well.
And if I could, then what shall I get there for?
A privilege, never to see me more. And from thy hated presence part I so. See me no more, whether he be dead or no.
There is no following this fierce vein. Here, therefore, for a while I will remain.
What hast thou done? About the wood go swifter than the wind, and Helena of Athens look thou find.
I go!
Flower of this purple dye, when is love he doth spy, let her shine as gloriously as Venus saw the sky. When thou wakest, if she be by, beg of her for remedy.
Helena is here at hand, and the youth mistook by me.
Stand aside. The noise they make will cause Demetrius to awake.
Why do you think I should woo in scorn?
These vows are Hermia's.
I had no judgment when to her I swore.
Nor none in my mind, now you give her o'er.
Demetrius loves her, and he loves not you.
Oh, Helena, goddess, nymph, perfect, divine, to what, my love, shall I compare thine eyne?
Oh, spite, I see you all are bent to set against me for your merriment, when I am sure you hate me with your hearts.
You are unkind, Demetrius. Be not so, for you love Hermia.
Never did mockers waste more idle breath.
Lysander, keep thy Hermia, I will none. If e'er I loved her, all that love is gone. Look where thy love comes, yonder is thy dear.
Uh-oh!
Why unkindly didst thou leave me so?
Why should he stay, whom love doth press to go?
What love could press Lysander from my side?
Fair Helena.
You speak not as you think, it cannot be.
Have you conspired? Have you with these contrived to bait me in this foul derision?
I scorn you not, it seems as you scorn me.
Have you not set Lysander as in scorn, to follow me and praise my eyes and face?
I understand not what you mean by this.
Fare you well.
Stay, my love, my life, my soul.
Fair Helena.
Oh, excellent.
Do not scorn her so.
Helena, I love thee, by my life, I do.
I say, I love thee more than he can do.
If thou say so, withdraw and prove it too.
Why are you grown so rude? Do you not jest? Am not I Hermia? Are not you Lysander?
'Tis no jest that I do hate thee and love Helena.
You juggler, you canker blossom, you thief of love. Fie, fie, you counterfeit, you puppet, you.
Puppets? Why so? Because I'm so dwarfish and so low? I am not yet so low as my nails can reach into thine eyes.
Though she be but little, she is fierce.
Little? Let me come to her.
Now follow if thou darest to try whose right is in thine or mine is most in Helena.
Follow? Nay, I'll go with thee cheek by jowl.
You mistress, all this coil is long of you.
I will not trust you, I, no longer stay in your cursed company.
I am amazed and know not what to say.
This is thy negligence. Still thou mistakest, or else committest thy knaveries willfully.
Believe me, King of Shadows, I mistook.
Ugh. Lead these testy rivals so astray as one come not within another's way. Like to Lysander sometime frame thy tongue, and sometimes rail thou like Demetrius. And from each other thou lead them thus, till their brows sleep doth creep. Then crush this herb into Lysander's eye. When they next wake, all this derision shall seem a dream.
Night, abate thy hours, and sleep, that sometimes shuts up sorrow's eye, steal me a while from mine own company.
Yet but three, come one more.
Never so weary, never so in woe. I can no further craw, no further go. Here will I rest me till the break of day.
Just do it!
Hurry up!
When thou wakest, thou takest true delight in the sight of thy former lady's eyes.
Wake up, wake up, it's Theseus!
But soft, what nymphs are these?
My lord, this is my daughter here asleep. And this lies, Xander. This Demetrius is, this Helena. I wonder of their being here together.
No doubt they rose up early to observe the rite of May.
Good morrow, friends. I pray you all stand up.
What? Oh!
I know you two are rival enemies. How come this gentle concord in the world?
My lord, I should reply amazedly. I cannot truly say how I came here. But, for truly what I speak, I came with Hermia hither.
Enough, enough, my lord! You have enough! I beg the law upon his head!
My lord, fair Helena told me of their stealth, of this their purpose hither to this wood, and I in fury hither followed them. Fair Helena and Fancy following me. But by some power it is, my love to Hermia melted as the snow. Now the object and pleasure of mine eye is only Helena. To her, my lord, was I betrothed ere I saw Hermia. But like a sickness that I loathe this food, but as in health come to my natural taste. Now I do wish it, love it, long for it, and will forevermore be true to it.
Fair lovers, you are fortunately met. Aegeus, I will overbear your will. For in the temple, by and by, with us, these couples shall eternally be knit. Away with us to Athens, three and three, we'll hold a feast in great solemnity. Come, Hippolyta.
Are you sure that we are awake? It seems yet we sleep. We dream. Was the Duke not just here and bid us follow him?
Yea, and my father.
And Hippolyta.
And he did bid us follow to the temple.
Why, then we are awake. Let's follow him. And by the way, let us recount our dreams.
To Athens!
Is everything okay now?
Yes, everything's okay.
What about that donkey guy?
Ugh, I forgot about him!
Come, sit thee down upon this flower again.
Now that's funny.
Shh!
Where's Peace Blossom?
Ready!
Scratch my head, Peace Blossom.
Oh, yes.
Cobweb!
My lord?
Help her scratch. Enough, I pray. Let none of your people stir me. I have an exposition of sleep upon me.
Sleep now, and I will wind thee in my arms. Fairies, be gone. Oh, how I love thee. How I dote on thee.
Ew!
Look, it's Oberon and Puck. They better fix this mess, too.
Her dotage now I do begin to pity. And now I have a changeling child. I will undo this hateful imperfection of her eyes.
My Oberon, what visions have I seen? Methought I was enamored of an ass.
There lies your love.
How came these things to pass? Oh, how mine eyes do loathe his visage now.
Silence a while. Robin, take off his head.
Now, when thou wakest with thine own fool's eyes, peep.
Come, my queen, take hands with me.
Tell me how it came this night that I sleeping here was found with these mortals on the ground.
When my shoe comes,
call me? I will. I have had a most rare vision, a dream. Man is but an ass if he goes about to expound this dream.
You have no idea.
Shh, methought I was. I will get Peter Quince to write a ballad of this dream. It shall be called Bottom's Dream. I shall perform it for the Duke.
What do you think?
Now is everything okay?
Yes, but it's not over yet. We have a party to go to.
We love parties!
We shadows have offended. Think but this, and all is mended, that you have but slumbered here while these visions did appear. And this weak and idle theme, no more yielding but a dream, gentles, do not reprehend. If you pardon, we will mend. Is I'm an honest puck, if you have an earned luck, now to scape the serpent's tongue, else a puck a liar call. So good night unto you all. Give me your hands if we be friends, and Robin shall restore amends.
¶¶